Hello and welcome to this course on Microsoft Office Excel 365. In this video, we will learn the five most common mathematical calculations done in Excel. The first one of them being add, second subtract, third divide, fourth multiply, and fifth average. So to add in Excel, we will be using this common data, which has, let's say, the sales figures for a company for the month of January, February, and March. Now, what we want to do is, we want to go ahead and add some numbers over here. So how do we do that? So let's put a column over here called sum. And now, to add in Excel, the easiest way is, that you click on the is equal to symbol and then select the cell you want to add, enter the plus symbol, select the next cell you want to add, then enter the plus symbol, select the other cell you want to add, press enter. You got your answer as 50. I'm using Format Painter now to go ahead and give it the same format. So it looks like the same. You can do it from here. So that was one way. There is another way. You do it by selecting the all cells together. So you press the symbol is equal to. That's most important. That is you telling Excel, I want to add. Or I want to do some calculation. It can be anything. So you enter the sign is equal to and then you type in the number 12, then the plus symbol, then type in the number 16, then the number 22. The same way that you would do in a calculator. And then press enter. You get the same answer, 50 again. Now, there is another way, which is equal to SUM. That's a formula now. It says adds all the numbers in a range. Wherein, you type is equal to sum, open the bracket like this, and then you select all three of these that you want to do a total. This is called a range then. Whatever continuous cells you have selected over here is a range. Press enter, you get your solution. Same 50. And more is equal to sum, open the bracket. Now you select this comma, then the next one comma. Instead of the plus symbol, you're using commas because you are using a formula. You'll still get the answer. Now why this is helpful is, now I'll tell you. Say for example, now why this is important, I'll tell you. Say for example, you want to total January's first number, Feb's last number, and March's first number. In that case, you will do is equal to sum, bracket open, January's first number, comma, Feb's last number, comma, and March's first number. Close the bracket. So that's where the comma comes in. Isn't it cool? So the best way is using the formula sum and then opening the bracket, selecting the cells, closing the bracket, pressing enter, you get your answer as sum. So there are multiple ways of doing it. This is the best way of adding numbers. Now if we were to go ahead and subtract the numbers. Now if I need to subtract something, say for example, I want to subtract the January sales from March sales. How do I do that? Is equal to, that is what we have to enter to tell Excel that we want to enter into the calculations mode. You type in 22 like in a calculator, type in the symbol minus and type in the number you want to deduct. January's total sales is 12 for the day 1. Enter, you get the answer as 10, which is right. 22 minus 12 is 10. Now there is no other formula for doing it. So this is the only way to do subtraction. So you simply type in the numbers or you select the numbers, but there is no formula. Now to select cells to subtract, you have to tell Excel that you want to go into the calculations mode. So you enter the symbol is equal to, then select the cell like this, enter the minus symbol and select the cell you want to deduct it from and enter, you get the answer. So that is how you subtract. Now, if I want to go ahead and divide, then again, there is no formula for divide. It's the same way you do in Excel. So like, for example, if I want to divide, so is equal to, I say 22 divided by, this is the symbol, divided by 12, press enter, is equal to 1.83. The other way is selecting the cells is equal to, select this number 22, divide symbol, and select the cell from which you divide, want to divide it by, enter, you get the same answer. Same for multiplication also. So if you want to multiply in Excel again is equal to 22 into 10. So this is the symbol for multiplication. You get the answer as 220. And in case of selecting the numbers, you type in is equal to, select this cell, multiplication symbol, select the other cell, you get the same answer, 264. Now, coming to averages, which is important. Because there is a formula for it and it's really important also. So we will do two, three ways of average. So is equal to AVERAGE. It says, returns the average arithmetic means of its arguments, which can be numbers or names, arrays or references that contains numbers. Simply says, it works only with numbers. So to do an average in Excel, you have to first type is equal to, then type the word average, open the bracket, and then select the cells containing the numbers for which you want to calculate the average. Like, I want to calculate the average of these three numbers. So I selected them together. Close the bracket, you get the average as 16.27. Another way. Is equal to average, you select these cells one by one. There has to be a comma in between them. 16.67. Why this method is important is because now if you want to do the average of the first number of January, comma, the last number of February, comma, and the first number of March, then this comma system helps you. So that's how you do average. Now you can do averages of different range. So average of first day's sales of Jan, Feb, March and average of last day sales of Jan, Feb, March. I want to do an average of these two ranges. Yes. Is equal to average. Select this range. Now, instead of closing the bracket, you bring in a comma. And then select this range. So it will give you an average of this and this. It is 22.167. So that is where Excel becomes interesting. So these are the five most commonly used mathematical calculations or operations that we do in Excel. So this was done in Office 365 Excel. I hope you like this video. If you do, please do click on like and subscribe. So until the next video, this is your guru now signing off for the day. Have a wonderful day ahead. Happy learning.